Hi, this is Dr. Minkoff, LifeWorks Wellness Center. We have some really exciting new news that I want to share with you about some treatments that we're doing at LifeWorks. First, a little bit of a background. About 3 or 4 months ago, I was at the Bulletproof Conference. I spoke there, and I ran into a friend of mine. This is Dr. Joe Mercola. I'm sure you've all heard of him. He's got the biggest natural website in the world. And he was looking particularly good, and we had some time to spend together. And he told me that he was getting some treatments that had actually de-aged him. So there is a test where you can look at what the actual age of your cells are compared to your chronological age. So let's say you've had 50 birthdays, but now there's a way to pretty accurately look at what age are your cells. If you're 50, are your cells actually 55 or 60? Like I saw someone yesterday, she's 50 years old, but her cells were 59. So she's aging too fast. Some people that we test, they're 50, but their actual age, if you look at their cells, is 55 or 54. So they're doing better. Their cells are aging slower than their actual chronological age. Now there's been a number of ways to measure this, but both of them look at these little segments at the end of the chromosomes of cells called telomeres. Now some labs are measuring telomeres directly, and there's a lot of controversy. Do you do telomeres of white blood cells or other cells? And sometimes the results on this have been tough to evaluate, or they weren't, you know, you couldn't get the same result if you tested it two times. So there's a new technology now which measures what is called DNA methylation. A methyl group in chemistry has a carbon and three hydrogens, and methyl groups get stuck on DNA, and the amount of methyl groups and where they are gives you a pretty accurate measure of how old your chromosomes actually are, or how old your cells are. So we're measuring this. And when I talked to Dr. Mercola, he said he'd gotten this treatment, and the treatment de-aged his cells, so his chromosomal age was whatever it was, and then after the treatment, about 6 months later, it was 3 years younger. Now that's pretty good. And on average, this treatment has de-aged people about 3 years for each treatment. The treatments can be given every 3 to 6 months. It's an easy treatment, and I'll tell you more about that in a minute. But now I want to tell you the technology that's behind it. So everyone I know of wants to age slower, wants to improve their health, and so this is the best I've found, and it's what my wife and I are using. And one of our sons got this treatment too, to help us age slower, or actually de-age. So here's the theory behind this. When a person is conceived, so it's a sperm from the father and an egg from the mother, and there is a union, and at that point, the clock starts to tick. And on the chromosome, there is an extra little piece called a telomere, and every time that one cell goes to two and two go to four, that telomere is kind of notched, and a notch comes off. And about 60 divisions is what a cell or daughter cells can do. And in molecular biology, this is called the Hayflick limit. Like a cell has a limited number of times that it can divide, and each time the telomere shortens, and when they get too short, then the cells don't divide, then they age, they can't repair, they can't make new daughter cells, and then you die. So all the cells in our body this happens to, except there are a group of cells which, when you're conceived, that clock, that button to start the aging, hasn't actually started yet. And these cells are called V cells. And that stands for very small embryonic-like cells. So they're embryo-like. And these cells have the potential to become any tissue in your body. So these cells are actually circulating around in your bloodstream all the time. If you're 5 years old, you have them. If you're 75 years old, you have them. And that's very interesting, but they're not turned on. So if someone gets stem cells from a 50-year-old, from their bone marrow or their fat, those cells are as old as they are. And so you may get some benefit from that, but what if you could turn on these V cells so they're in an embryonic state, and at 50 years old, you had a way where you could turn them on, and then they became active, but they're basically brand new. They have 60 cycles that they can divide. And if they're put into your body, they could go to areas where you have pain or heart's not good or you're losing your memory and regenerate you or renew you. And in the process, your chromosome age, when measured by DNA methylation, as I talked about before, goes back an average of 3 years. Now, of course, you can't promise anyone when you do this that everyone's going to be the same, but this has been the average in the experimental data that's been going on. Okay? So a brilliant scientist, medical doctor, has developed a specialized type of laser with a specialized lens on the laser that if you shine it on these V cells, they activate. Okay? So if you take tubes of blood from someone and you separate out the cell part of the blood from the liquid part of the blood called the plasma, and you expose the plasma to the specialized laser, the V cells that are asleep, these embryonic-like stem cells that are asleep, they activate. And then if you put them back into the body, they begin to regenerate areas, especially where there's malfunction, inflammation, problem. Now this laser, it also turns out, helps to direct these cells to where they're supposed to go. So if someone has a chronic heart condition, then the laser can be directed at the heart. Now a very interesting study was just published this year in peer-reviewed literature of a group of 10 people who had hearts that just didn't pump very well. Now, a normal heart, when it squeezes, empties out about 55 or 60% of the blood that's inside of it. That's called ejection fraction. So if you have a heart echo, the cardiologist is measuring what your ejection fraction is. And if you're a healthy person, it's 55 or 60. If someone's had a heart attack and they've damaged their heart muscle, like some of the heart muscle died, or they've had a viral infection or a chemical injury to their heart muscle, their heart may not be pumping that well. And so what happened was, is a group of people, 10 people, who had ejection fractions of only 14% on average. Now at 14%, it is very difficult to even walk. These people are what are called cardiac cripples. The heart is so weak that it's difficult for them to do much. On average, 70% of these people will die within a year of having that diagnosis made because their heart just can't pump and it can't service their body and they just can't, it just doesn't work, okay? So they took 10 of these people with an average ejection fraction of 14%. They got one treatment of these V cells, and at 5 years, 80% of them were still alive. And on average, it doubled their ejection fraction from 14% to 28%. Now, a person at 28% is in much better shape. They can walk around. They may be able to even go up and down stairs. So this is a very powerful thing, because modern medicine, other than a heart transplant, doesn't really have anything that will improve this kind of thing in a body. So that's one treatment over 5 years, very much improved it. Now, there's been other improvements in other people, so that you can sort of look at, not only do their chromosomes look better or their telomeres look better, but their overall performance looks better. And so some of the elite athletes around, NBA players, professional boxers, they've been getting these treatments with an improvement in performance. So we are now, there's only five other places in the world that are delivering this treatment. I met with a doctor who trains other doctors in how to do that. And he came to our clinic. He helped us to get this started. And so we are now delivering this V-cell treatment. So if you have areas where you have medical problems that you want to improve, like your heart isn't working well or your pancreas isn't working well, this would be ideal. It seems to work very well in people who have chronic pulmonary conditions, you know, like lung disease, chronic fibrosis, COPD, things like that. Maybe even post-infection with the epidemic that's going around where lung function just isn't right. So this isn't a guarantee, of course, but it's a treatment that is very safe. It can be done easily. It takes about 2 hours. It is not painful. And then what we've been doing is measuring the level of the telomeres up front, the DNA methylation up front. And then 4 or 5 months later, remeasuring them to show what's happening. And overall, it's been very exciting and very good. So if you want more information, just contact us. We have some written literature on it. There's been three papers published this year in peer review literature on this subject, and they are available. So let us know. I'm very excited by this. My wife and I, as I said, have gotten this treatment, and we both feel change. The things that I noticed the most were change in blood sugar regulation. Like my blood sugar, I'm not a diabetic, but I watch very carefully my blood sugar. And I'm very careful about how many carbohydrates I eat in a day, because everyone in my family has diabetes and many of them are obese and they have heart disease, and I don't want to get those things. And I've noticed a great improvement in blood sugar regulation, also in sleep, also athletic recovery and athletic performance. I'm still racing triathlons and I can see the difference in my athletic performance since getting these V-cell treatments. So I'm excited about this. As I said, if you want more information, contact our office. And I really hope that you take advantage of this, because this is an extreme breakthrough in medicine that we want to share with you. Okay? Hope you're well.